Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to be working on one of the traveling journals that I have here. This one is from my friend Joey in Oregon. And her theme is cats. So I am going to be working on this blank page to make a cat for her. And what I was thinking, since I had some cool super texture fabric here with me, I was thinking of making this for the belly of the kitty as a texture, plus some gesso, or maybe glue it first with a medium and then paint a kitty over that. So I'm going to be protecting the pages under here, and I'm going to start speeding up the process. I hope you enjoy it. Okay, now I will have to wait for this to dry, and I will come back with some gesso. So this is the next day, and I decided that instead of the gesso, I'm going to use just fluid acrylic in white to cover the fabric, because I am going to make a, well, most likely, a tuxedo kitty. But even if I decided to make a different kind of kitty, I would like to paint this and leave it just as a texture. And the fluid acrylic is going to go easier in every little part of the thick texture here, better than the gesso. So I am going to give it a good coating of paint. Later on, most likely I'm going to add some pink to it. Okay, so now that I have the white down, I am going to use the gesso, but in the background. And my gesso is very thick, which is something that I like, because it leaves a bunch of texture that you can make in little swirls if you want, or just brushwork that is very noticeable when you paint over it. And it's a lot of fun. So wherever I'm going to have my background, I will apply a little bit. In zigzaggies. You don't have to make so much texture if you prefer it a little more kind of like soft texture, or just the protection of the gesso for the paper. Either way is fine. Okay, I think that's enough. And now I'm going to let it dry. And in the meantime, I'm going to be deciding if I want a tabby or a tuxedo kitty like mine, or something else. For now, I know that I would like this blue and something green down here. So I'm just going to wait for it to dry now, and then I'll come back with color. Okay, this is totally dry. So now I'm going to put some metallic blue. It's called Peacock Pearl from DecoArt. You can use any color that you want, but I think I want to use some metallics. So that's what I have here. And most likely I'm thinking about mixing it with some other blue, wet on wet. I will have a little mixture over here. And of course the paint is not working. Okay. The other color is not metallic. And on top of that, I'm going to add some matte to it. But I think it's going to look pretty cute. Okay, to make more of a contrast, I'm going to have some white as well. I always like to see very much or very many shades of the same color. And we're still going to have the white here. Sorry, but I cannot paint and talk at the same time. All right. It is a simple background, but with a lot of texture, and I think it turned out very pretty. Now the green area, just a suggestion of grass. And I think I will come back later when it's dry with some more texture. And some lines with ink, probably. All right. I'm going to let it dry and then I will come back with, I think I'm going to make it black and white, like my kitty, because I like him so much. But I need to have this completely dried, so I will be back in a couple of minutes. I'm going to be making a little cloud over here, and everything is dry already, so right after the cloud, I will start working on the kitty. And I just will use a little water. I don't want it too precise. Just some puffiness here and there. Okay, that should be enough. Now with my black, I guess I'm going to start with a very skinny brush, but I will just go around, maybe, I think I need an old one that is a little wider, but it's still little, this one. So it's scribbly and scribbly, but not too thick. I want it a little zigzaggy. Thank you. Okay, the paint is still too wet, so I cannot go and give it a second coat. So I'm going to wait a little bit for this to dry better, and then I will go give it a second coat and put my little pinks and the outlining of the little feet and everything else. So I'll be back in a couple of minutes. I'm still going to come back with some little details like the whiskers and finishing the eyes, but I wanted you to see so far how the kitty is looking. Okay, I'm going to let the eyes dry and then I will come back with some more highlights. I'm going to make some little white whiskers. So you can see better. We're a little closer here. Also a little bit more white. So this white marker is getting stained with the black paint. So I'll do it again. There we go. It's one of those that you need to squeeze against something several times. Oh. Well, I can always come back with a black marker, because I went all over the place. But that's okay. Okay, now the whiskers are just going to be probably over here. All right. and with the black marker. I'm going to wait a little bit for the white area to dry and give him some little eyelashes maybe. But pretty much it is done. This is a little close up. I think he turned out really cute. Thanks for watching this video. And if this is the first time that you're visiting, I hope you will find something in my channel to make you click on this little button that says subscribe. And you will be receiving YouTube's emails notifications every time I upload a video, which is Tuesdays and most Thursdays for now. And the odd day when I'm in a video challenge. So leave me a comment in the box below, and if you want to connect with me, there are also links in the information area below this video where you can see where else I post. And talk to you soon. See you later. Bye-bye.